This is Mission Control Houston, a very busy day on board the International Space Station as the crew on board, Commander Dan Burbank, fellow NASA astronaut Don Pettit, European Space Agency astronaut Andrei Kuipers, and Russian cosmonauts Anton Shkaplerov, Anatoly Ivanishin, and Oleg Kononenko continue their work. Today's activities focusing on a variety of different experiment and maintenance tasks aboard the orbiting outpost. It's currently at an altitude of 240 statute miles on a southeasterly track over Southeast Asia, heading for a crossing over the central portion of Australia on this orbit. Here in the Christopher C. Kraft Jr. Mission Control Center in Houston, Chris Edelin is the flight director on console in charge of the team. He's got Josh Matthew available to talk with the crew on any number of different activities that the crew might have questions or need information on. And he's also got communication with flight control rooms around the world in Europe, Russia, and Japan, where they are helping to manage the experiment activities aboard the multinational research outpost. Today, another busy day as the crew is focusing primarily on the SLICE experiment, which is an experiment that looks at combustion and with research activities into how the human body reacts to microgravity. Dan Burbank also conducting some maintenance on the space station's food warmer device and installing a couple of joint space station local area network power and data cables into the Harmony module that'll help collect it to the European Space Agency provided Columbus module. Don Pettit, again, working with the SLICE operations, and Andrei Kuipers is taking photographs of the evaluation and monitoring of biofilms inside ISS, or the viable payload. He's also doing some maintenance on the waste recovery system. This is some live video of the combustion experiment that's going on right now, the SLICE experiment. For more information about that, you can go to www.nasa.gov/slice. Or www.nasa.gov/station. Just to recap the week, again, it's been a very busy week. On board Monday, the crew worked with some maintenance activities. They did a replacement on the advanced resistive exercise device. It's one of the ropes that's used in the different exercises that they perform. They also had a downlink for the NASA Future Forum honoring the 50th anniversary of astronaut John Glenn's first American orbits of the Earth. On Tuesday, they worked with a variety of different experiments, one of those the Sprint experiment. They also did some cleaning in the Leonardo Permanent Multipurpose Module. They worked with the microgravity small payload rack combustion chamber, preparing it for some samples. On Wednesday, they had an educational event with a consortium of schools in New Jersey. And they did a lot of ventilation system maintenance in the Columbus module, checking all of those ventilation systems to make sure that they're providing good airflow. Here's some video of Dan Burbank, who worked on that with Andrei Kuipers in particular, as they checked all of the seals and the fans and the ventilation system ducts that are used to circulate air throughout the space station, making sure in this case that those in the Columbus module are working very well. Very important for the crew to have good air circulation so that they don't have carbon dioxide bubbles form around their heads, which could be a health hazard for them. They also had some EVA tool stowage activities. Dan Burbank stowed the American pieces that were used by his Russian cosmonauts as they went out the previous week on a spacewalk to move a large cargo boom on the outside of the pier's docking compartment to another docking compartment outside the station. And the crew also worked on the capillary flow experiment. This particular experiment portion was the vein experiment, where they look at how fluids flow in unusually shaped containers with the goal to be able to improve our understanding and the mathematical models that are used to build, in particular, tanks that are used to hold fluids for rocket engines that are used in space, as microgravity fluids flow differently. This is some video of some of the documentation of that capillary flow experiment vein system overview that occurred. On Thursday, it was work with the atmosphere revitalization bacteria filter. They did some cleaning on that. And Don Pettit did some additional work with the capillary flow experiment. And that brings us up to date for this week. The crew is going to have an easy weekend, just some routine maintenance activities and some time off to rest and relax before they get back to their full work week of experiment activities later on next week.